Okay, so the first question we have this week is from Ismath, and he says, it's a simple question. Everyone says it's a simple question. I have a grid application, and it has four columns as follows. One, invoiced amount, 1,500. Two, invoice cost, 1,000. Three, profit, 500. And then four, profit margin, which is 33.33%. I have grid total for all four columns, how it works for margin column. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you what Ismath has done here, and then I'm going to provide you with the solution. Okay, so here, first of all, let me come into Scriptcase, and hopefully I'm still logged in. And right now I am viewing actually the samples project or template that is available within Scriptcase to everybody. If you haven't checked this out, do generate it, do have a look at it. I know some of the examples, they may look a bit basic, but it provides you the features and functionalities of, you know, what you are actually wanting to apply within your own project, more than likely. So if that is something you are, if there is something you are struggling with or want to know how to do something, you pretty much have every example within this template. Okay, so here within the grid applications, if I just come here to say any grid application, I choose one of these here with the link. And if I open up this one and run this application, we will see here that we have a basic grid, just like a Ismath has there. And in his case, maybe you have an extra few fields here for calculation. So if we would take an example of order price times then the order, okay? And if we would then basically create that or perform that calculation within our grid, which is what Ismath has done here, he is not using the automatic calculation, okay? So the automatic calculation comes here from the data, and then your calculation, which would be the margin field, which is why it's not provided within the grand summary. So if I come here to the grid, for instance, and I add an extra field, and I'll just call this, well, I'll call it margin field as well. Okay, and then this is the field that Ismath has available there within his grid. And then he's come here to the event, and on record, here we have then provided a calculation for that field. So say, for instance, the margin field would then equal, say, 800% or whatever a value, okay? And in that case, we then have 800 along the value, so the new calculation that is then provided. Okay, so this will not be automatically calculated within the grand summary. Okay, so what Ismath is trying to do here, what we see here within this, it's pretty much the same thing here without the grand summary. So let's go ahead and maybe apply some of those features. So if I come down here, I want to first of all group some of my data so that I can enable the summaries and so forth. So if I group then here, for instance, via, say, order date, and I'll just run that. We have there the grid totals and everything as well. Okay, and now we have here our years and everything else. Now we want to apply here the grid totals, and that would then be here a margin or, you know, whatever fields here that we want to apply. And here for the summary totals, then the record count. So here, if I apply the grid totals, that field would not work. So we'll see that in a moment. So we have there also the order price. So let me find here the order price, price order. Let's add that here also within the grid totals and move that up. And we can see straight away here for the price order, I have a sum, and for the margin, I have a count, okay? So I'm already not receiving the sum functionality. Okay, I only have a count option, all right? So then if I go ahead and run that now, okay, we have then those details applied. We should have then also our grid totals applied here. So let's come here to our settings and apply here, first of all, tree view. Let's also group by the header because that's quite nice. And we also want to maybe use here some dynamic totalization, okay, so because that allows here the totals to be displayed. So if I go ahead and run that application again, and it is running now. Did run. Okay, so I'm still not being displayed here the grid total. So it's probably at the end here. Let's go here to the end and find our totals. Oh, there's a lot of data in here, right? the whole year. Okay, so let's actually change that group so we actually can see what's going on here. And we want to then change here the order date settings, and we can change here for the year. And then let's go, for instance, year and month, year and week. Let's do year and week and then run that again. And now we can see we have then here our totals displayed, but for the margin, well, that's going to be zero all the time. And this is the problem that ISMAF is pretty much having, that this calculation here is provided via the data, and this one is not, because it is a manual field and essentially manual data that is being applied. So how to get around that? Okay, so to your question, ISMAF, now that everyone also understands what you are doing there, that calculation, so this calculation you are doing, I would advise to place that into a field. Okay, so store that data. And then once that data is stored, the calculations will all be automated within the applications. And at the same time, you can also generate the charts and use some of the other applications and some of the default functionality that is available within the Scriptcase applications. If you are generating data, then some of the features will not function unless you apply them. Okay. So to our next question, I hope that answers your question. It is Math. I see you're not there today, so it's a shame you can't tell me, but maybe you can let me know via email. Hopefully that solves your problem. I think it will actually solve your problem, because that is a very typical question I get very often. My group summary, my summary is not being displayed with my calculated.